I gave her oral sex.
You gave who oral sex?
Jessica.
Was she alive?
Thank you.
All right, it's Monday, February 26, 2007, and it's approximately 5:18 Eastern Time. And we are at 1024 Capitol Center Drive in Frankfort, Kentucky, at the Office of the Attorney General in Conference Room C. And we're conducting a videotaped interview of Victoria Caldwell. Present in the room with me is KBI Commissioner David James, Agent Lee Wise, the Kentucky Bureau of Investigation, and Agent Bob O'Neill, the Kentucky Bureau of Investigation. My name is Scott Crawford Sutherland. I'm an Assistant Attorney General, Director of the Special Prosecutions Division, and Special Prosecutor in charge of the case related to the murder, alleged murder of Jessica Curran in Graves County, Kentucky. Ms. Caldwell, you have come to this place of your own free will,
yes.
Correct? And I'm going to ask you to speak up as loud as you can, be as clear as you can. You're here on your own accord.
Yes.
And nobody's promised you anything for being here.
No.
Made any threats to you.
No.
Offered you anything for your statement in this case,
yeah.
And you've agreed to speak with me. I know you've already spoken with Agent O'Neill and Agent Wise. On a couple of occasions, you've agreed to speak with me and follow up to that. All right. Background information, just for me. State your full name and spell it for me for the record.
It's Victoria Colum, VICTORIACALDWELL.
And do you have a middle name?
Victoria's middle name. Oh, my first name is Doris. It's DORIS.
Doris Victoria Caldwell.
Right.
Your birthday?
It's 12185.
Your social security number?
It's 400-27-1391.
And where do you currently live?
1240 U.S. Buffalo Lane, Apartments in Sacramento, California.
Okay, that was really quick and not very loud. Let's try it. Slow down and speak up a little bit.
It's 1240 West Bethel Lane, Apartment 10E, Santa Maria, California.
And what's the zip code there?
93458.
And how long have you been living at your current address?
2 years.
Prior to that, where did you live?
I can't remember the address, but it was in Santa Maria.
It was in Santa Maria. Was it an apartment complex?
Yes.
What was the name of the apartment complex?
The Meridians.
Meridians. And how long did you live there?
For a year, actually.
Okay. Before that, where did you live? House or apartment?
It was a condo, actually.
Okay. Was it a condo complex?
Yes.
Okay. Do you remember the name of it?
No. I just know that I was on East Park Street.
East Park Street in Santa Maria?
Yes.
Okay. And prior to that, where did you live?
With my mom. I don't know the name of that street. What I was in there.
And what about before that?
There's so many places.
Okay. Was it a house or an apartment or?
I think it was a house.
Okay. All right. What about before that?
and Kentucky for that.
All right. Now, who do you currently live with?
With my fiance and my kids.
Does your mother live with you?
No.
Does she live in Santa Maria?
Yes.
Any other family members live in Santa Maria?
Yes.
Who is that?
My uncle. And my little brother.
Your uncle. What's his name?
Clarence Waterfield.
Okay. And how's he related to you?
That's my mom's uncle. It's my great uncle.
Okay. And your brother?
It's Mario.
He lives in Santa Maria?
Yeah, he lives with me.
He lives with you?
Yes.
And do you remember, how long have you been in Santa Maria, California?
I think about 5 years, I think.
Do you remember when you moved out there?
Right before Christmas.
Yeah, right before Christmas of?
Almost 2000, I think, I'm not sure.
All right. Was it the same year that Jessica Curran was murdered?
Yes.
All right, so she was murdered in July. You moved out to California in December.
Right.
All right. All right. So she died in July 2000, and you moved out in December of 2000. So you will have been there a little over 6 years, I guess. Does that sound right?
Yeah, something like that. I'm not sure.
But it was definitely the year that Jessica was murdered.
Yes.
All right. Okay. Now, that's sort of the current thing. I'm going to take you back.
Okay.
Where were you born?
In Paducah, Kentucky.
What's your mother's name?
Wanda Davis.
And your father's name?
My real father?
Yes, your real father.
James C. Berry.
James?
C. Berry.
C. Berry. Okay. And how long did you live in Paducah?
I never lived in Paducah. That's where I was born, but I'm from Vannaville.
From where?
Vannaville.
Spell that for me.
VLANDVILLE.
Blandville. What county is that?
Ballard.
Ballard County. When you were born, did your mom and your real father live together?
No.
Okay. Did you ever live with your real father?
Yes.
How many brothers and sisters do you have?
I have two sisters and two brothers.
Are they full sisters or two full brothers or halves?
My brother, Mario and Brandy, they have different parents.
Mario and who?
Brandy.
You know Mario's dad's name?
Their dad's Curtis Davis.
Curtis Davis. And what about Brandy?
That's her dad also.
Okay. And your brother, or you have another brother?
Yeah, that's my brother, Donald.
And Mr. Berry is his father, obviously.
Right.
All right. And you have another sister?
Yes, Rosie.
Rosie, does she go by any other name?
No.
And her father?
It's also James.
All right, how long did you live in Blandville?
Until I was in third grade.
And where'd you go to elementary school? If you remember.
It was Bell County Elementary.
Until third grade?
Yes.
Then where did you go?
I moved to Mayfield.
Who did you move to Mayfield with?
With my grandma.
Any other family?
In Mayfield?
Is it just you and your grandma?
It was myself and I think. I know my twin brother was there, but the other ones, they weren't there.
So you and your brother Donald lived with your grandmother?
Right.
Just her?
Yeah, just my grandma.
Where did she live?
In the Black Projects.
You know, that's what they call them, the Black Projects?
Yeah.
They have a name?
The Black Projects
That's what you do, the name is Mayfield Project. And where did you go to school in Mayfield, or did you?
I think it's Longfellow.
Longfellow?
Yeah.
And how long did you finish elementary school in Mayfield?
After sixth grade, I moved.
After sixth grade?
Mm-hmm.
All right. And where'd you move to?
First, I went to St. Louis, Missouri.
St. Louis?
Yes.
And who did you move to St. Louis with?
With my mom and her husband.
Mr. Davis?
Yes.
How long did you live there?
I'll say maybe like 4 months.
Why did you move to St. Louis?
My mom was running from the law.
Okay, where was she living when you were in Mayfield with your grandmother?
Stanley.
No, but where was she living?
I don't know. I think Memphis is like that. I'm not really
did you sure. See her?
Not really.
On occasion?
Every once in a while.
Okay, so why did she take you with her at St. Louis?
Because I think she kind of figured that because if the police were looking for her, that would tell them where she was or tell them where her mom was. So, I don't know, then she just took us.
Your grandmother, is that your mom's mother?
Yes.
Okay. So did Donald go too? To St. Louis?
Yes, he did.
All right. So, how old is Mario, if you know?
No. Mm-hmm. He is 20.
And Brandy?
She is 23.
And Donald
is 22.
22. And Rosie?
I think she was 25.
All right. Now, when you say you lived in St. Louis for 4 months, did you go to school while you were there?
No.
Then where'd you go?
Well, then I went to California.
Where in California?
To Santa Maria.
And why did you go to Santa Maria then?
I don't know.
You know why they moved out there? Your family out there?
Well, my uncle lived out there, and then his daughter lived out there also, my cousin.
Okay, so your uncle is, again, who?
Clarence Waterfield.
And is that your mother's brother?
No, that's my grandma's brother.
Okay, so he's your great uncle.
Right.
That's your mom's mother's brother.
Right.
All right. Gotcha. And, okay. So you moved out there, and this is sometime around when you would have been in the seventh grade, I guess. If you left to go to St. Louis after your sixth grade year, and you stayed there 4 months, I'm assuming that you were somewhere around when you would have been in the seventh grade.
When I went to Santa Maria, I was still in sixth grade.
Okay. So did you go to sixth grade there?
Yes.
Right. And how long did you stay in Santa Maria?
Until I was in beginning of eighth grade. Yeah.
And some of this, I mean, is just as best you can recall, okay? And I know this is going back, because I know you moved around a lot. All right, so at the beginning of 8th grade, what did you do?
We moved to Barlow, next.
Kentucky?
Right.
And is that also in Ballard County?
Yes.
Who moved to Ballard County?
It was myself, my twin brother, my little brother.
Mario?
Yes.
Okay.
And my other sister, she was on her own. The other sister, I don't know where she was.
And your mom?
No, she left us. She left us there. A little bit.
Okay, but she moved you back.
Mm-hmm.
Did she move you back to Barlow?
Yes.
And who were you staying with?
I was with my grandma.
In Barlow?
Yes.
Okay, so Your mother brought you and Donald and Mario back to Barlow. And you all stayed with your grandmother.
Right. Well, I live with my grandma. My brothers live with my oldest cousin.
Okay. What's your grandmother's name?
Yours. I think it's Caldwell.
Barlow with your grandmother still for how long?
Until mom came back and then I started my freshman year in Mayfield. So
when you were getting ready to start your freshman year in Mayfield, you moved there about the time you were starting your freshman year in high school.
Where?
To Mayfield.
Yes.
And who were you living with there?
When I first got there, we were living with Tamara and her mom and her brother.
First, with Tamara. And what's Tamara's last name?
Caldwell.
And how do you spell that? How do you spell Tamara?
T-A-M-R-A.
You don't have R. All right. And with who else?
Her mom.
What's her name?
Brenda Jackson.
And who else?
And then Calvin's brother, Patrick.
Calvin.
Right.
And was there? And you were there with who else?
It was myself and my sister, Brandy.
Okay. Had your grandmother passed away then?
No.
So she still lived in Barlow?
Yes.
She didn't move to Mayfield with you?
No.
And was your mother there in Mayfield when you first moved?
Not really, but a little bit, yeah.
How did you come to move from Barlow to Mayfield?
What do you mean?
Well, you were living in Barlow with your grandmother. Mm-hmm. And then all of a sudden you moved to Mayfield your freshman year and were staying with Tamara and Brenda and Patrick and you and Brandy. Why did that happen? As best you can remember. What was the impetus for you moving down to Mayfield when you started your freshman year? Did your mother want you there? Was your grandmother sick? What was the reason you left your grandmother's house?
I have no idea.
You don't remember?
No.
Okay. And how are you related to Tamara Caldwell?
She's my cousin.
Okay. More specific than that.
Yeah, she's
my cousin. Who is she related to?
Her mom is my aunt, which is my mom's sister.
Okay. Brenda Jackson is your mom's sister.
Yes.
Okay. So Patrick and Tamara are your first cousins.
Right.
All right. And had you had much contact with them before that you moved to Mayfield as a kid?
Yes.
And how so?
Their mom used to check on us all the time. Because when I lived with my grandma, Brenda, they all lived out there. A couple of my aunts, they lived out there. And they all check on my grandma because my grandma was always taking care of us or somebody else's kids in our family. So.
Did they live in the projects too? Yeah.
They lived in the white projects.
When you moved to Mayfield, right, when you started school, do you remember the street address where they lived, or what street it was on, that house?
I don't remember this, but I know it's right across the street from the Midtown restaurant.
The Midtown restaurant. And is that in town? In Mayfield proper?
Yes.
Okay. How long did you stay there? Do you remember what month it was when you moved down to Mayfield in relation to when you started school? Was it summertime or was it the middle of school?
It No, it was summer high.
And the next fall, you started at Mayfield as a freshman?
Yes.
All right, you, so you went your freshman year, you started your freshman year there at Mayfield High School. Did you finish a whole year of school there? At Mayfield?
No.
Okay. Is that the fall she, Jessica was murdered? If you moved there in the summer, she was murdered on July the 30th, and school started the 1st of August. Had you just moved there, or was it the next year? You hear what I'm saying? Had you, you moved to Mayfield, and you started your freshman year. Had you gone, either you moved there and she was murdered and you started school then, or you were there a whole year and were getting ready to start your sophomore year?
I wasn't there for a whole year.
Okay. So did this happen before you even started your freshman year? The murder?
Yes.
All right. So you moved to Mayfield in the summer. Jessica was murdered on July the 30th. And you started school probably that next week at Mayfield High School.
Yes.
All right. And you stayed there until when?
Until right before Christmas.
And then you left.
Yes.
All right. Now, when you moved, you moved over to the house where Brenda Jackson and your cousin Tamara Caldwell and Patrick Caldwell. It was you and your sister Brandy, and it's a house that's right across from the Midtown restaurant.
Yeah.
What's the house look like?
It's blue. And
it was blue at the time?
Mm-hmm.
Okay. It's a blue house, ranch or two story?
I don't know what I would call it.
It had more than one floor?
No.
It was all on the same floor?
Yes.
No stairs going up to the second floor?
No.
Did it have a basement?
Not that I remember.
Okay. How long did you stay there?
I don't know. I think it was just, it wasn't that long.
Days? Weeks?
Maybe weeks.
Or months?
Maybe weeks.
Then where did you go?
Then we moved into a greenhouse.
And where was that house located?
Oak Street.
And who lived at that house?
It was myself, my mom, her husband, and my sister, Randy.
Okay. Now, did you move to that house before or after Jessica was murdered? Where were you living when Jessica was murdered?
We have two houses, but the main house was the green
one. Oak Street house.
Yeah.
Okay. And when you say you had two houses?
We're renting one, buying the other.
Okay. You were buying a house at the time of your parents' home?
Yeah.
Or your stepfather and your mother?
Yes.
Okay. Did you move into the greenhouse on Oak Street before they bought the house?
Yes.
So, you were living, you moved in the summer, and you moved into the Oak Street house with your mom and Mr. Davis and Sister Brandy before Jessica was murdered?
Yes.
And that's where you were staying behind the wall?
Yes.
Okay. Now, when was the first time, Victoria, When was the first time that you were aware that something was going to happen to Jessica Kern?
What do you mean?
Well, were you aware that Jessica Kern was going to get killed that night? When was the first time that you were aware that there was something going on here in relation to it? Well, let me do it this way. Let's talk about the day, the Saturday, which would have been the 29th, I think. Do you remember where you were that day?
Yes.
Okay, where were you?
First I was at home, and then I went to Tamara's house.
So when you woke up on Saturday morning, and if my dates are off, I'm going to say this is the Saturday morning. I'm going to call it July 29th because I think that's what it was. Saturday, July 29th, you woke up at the Oak Street house.
Yes.
And you went to Tamara Caldwell's house.
Yes.
What time did you go over there, if you remember? What time of day was it? Was it morning, afternoon, or night?
No, it was morning.
All right. You went to Tamara Caldwell's house in the morning. And who was there when you got there, if you can remember?
It was Tamara and then her son Kevin was there for a little bit.
So when you got there, Tamara was there,
mm-hmm.
Kevin, who else? Just the two of them. Okay, what were you doing? What did you go over there for?
We usually always walk over there on Saturdays.
To do what?
Just to go over there.
Okay. So what were you doing there during that morning? While you and Tamara were there, what were you all doing?
I remember I was in her room listening to music.
Did you do any drugs?
No.
You sure?
Yes.
Okay. Now, did you stay there throughout the day? Anybody else come to the house while you were there?
Yes.
Okay. And who came and at what time of the day in relation to when you got there? Was it morning, afternoon, or evening?
It was in the morning. Quincy had came over.
Quincy. What's his last name?
Right? Right.
You're sure he came there in the morning? That Saturday morning?
Yes.
All right. How did he get there?
I don't know.
Was he driving a car?
Not that I remember.
Did he just show up at the house?
Yes.
Was he with anybody?
No.
All right. When was the first time you noticed that he was there?
When he had opened the front door. His car was right there by the living room.
So at that point, you were in the living room?
Yes.
Is this before or after you went to listen to music? So you were just hanging out at the house, basically?
Yes.
And was Tamara hanging out with you, or?
Yes.
So were you all listening to music together?
Yes. We always do.
Okay. And how, is she, was she the same age?
No.
How old was she? If you can remember, roughly. Was she a teenager? Was she older than 20 at that time?
I don't remember.
Do you know how old she is now?
I think she's like 26 right now. I'm not sure.
All right. Well, she's older than you then.
Mm-hmm.
If she's 26, let's just say she's 26, then she would have been about 19. Something like that. roughly. So that would make her four, maybe three, four, 5 years older than you were. That was that your understanding? She was 3, 4, 5 years older than you?
Yeah.
Older than you?
Yeah, 100 years older.
All right. So when Quincy Cross came to Tamara's house, you say it was in the morning.
Yes.
You're sure about that?
I'm positive.
All right. And he was by himself.
Yes.
And you don't know how he got there.
No.
And he was, all right, so were you sitting in the living room by yourself?
No.
Okay, who was with you?
My sister.
Okay, your sister?
Randy.
Okay, did she go with you over there?
Yes.
Okay, well, I left that out. So when you went over to Tamara's that morning, was you and Brandy, anybody else? I asked you who else was there and you didn't mention her name.
Oh, Brandy.
Okay. I guess you were thinking, maybe you were thinking of people that were there when you got there, but it was, so it was you, Brandy, Tamara, and Kevin.
Yeah.
All right, so when Quincy got there, who was there?
Myself, my sister.
Your sister?
Brandy.
Brandy Caldwell.
Right.
And who else?
Tamara.
Okay. So, tell me about that. Tell me what transpired while he was there. Well, let me ask you this. Do you remember what he was wearing? Do you have any idea what kind of clothes he was wearing that morning? If you know.
No.
All right. did you know Quincy Cross before he came that morning?
I didn't, know him, but I didn't know him.
You knew of his name?
No, my cousin's sold drugs for him.
Okay, so you knew him because your cousin sold drugs for him?
Yeah.
And who were your cousin?
Patrick and Eric Caldwell.
Okay. And did you know him to see him?
Only times I've really seen him when they did, their deals.
Okay, but when he walked in that morning, did you know who he was?
Yes.
Did you know that's Quincy Cross?
Yes.
Okay. tell me about that. I want you to go back in that house and in that living room, and I want you to think about what was going on in that house while he was there. And I want you to tell me. You know what I'm saying?
Yes.
Can you see yourself in that room? In the house there? Can you see him there?
Yes.
Can you see Tamara there? And Brandy.
Yes.
And I want you to put yourself back in that house, and I want you to tell me exactly what transpired while you're in the house. Exactly what happened to the best of your memory.
Well, he was talking about Quincy. He was kissing all over my cousin and all that stuff like that. And my cousin had told him that to stop or no or whatever, and then she told him, he said I was cute or something like that, and then she told him that he could touch on me, and then she told me that that was okay.
Okay.
And so.
Tell me about that.
I had went into the room.
Where was he kissing on your?
In the hallway, right in front of her, where the.
All right, we're back on the record. We just changed the disc for the video recorder. Victoria, I asked you how you knew Quincy Cross was kissing on your cousin Tamara. And you just take it from there. I want you to walk me through exactly what happened in the house.
Well, there's like a couch and then there's a lazy boy recliner that's like where the hallway is. So I was sitting right there and he was like kissing all over here because I seen him do it. And my cousin told him to know and stuff. And then he stopped and then I think he went to the restroom and she just told me to come back there with her. And besides, I had went into the room with her or whatever. And then
what room is that?
Her room, her bedroom.
Bedroom, okay.
And when I had went to the room with her or whatever, he started in again, like kissing her. And then she told him to stop again, and then that's when she told him that. That's when he said that I'm here or whatever, and then my cousin told him that he can like touch me or whatever. And
what do you mean? Is that what she said? You can touch me? What did she say?
She said that he can touch me. And then he just started to kiss me. And then he was like, he started kissing me, and then he was like grabbing my breast, and he started touching my lower area, but I pushed his hand away. And then, like, right then, that's when I didn't understand my cousin. She walked out of the room. And so he shut the door. And then, he pushed me back onto the bed. And then that's when he ripped my pants off. Because I didn't have on, like, jeans, but I had on, like, these light pants. And he, like, ripped them off. And he set up, like, right beside me or whatever. And then he started to have sex with me or whatever. And
he just started that sex with you.
And then
did you tell him to stop at any
point? Yeah, but he didn't. She doesn't like it.
Did you tell him to stop?
Yes, but he doesn't like going out.
So he started to have sex with you. Did he penetrate you?
Yes.
Okay. So, did he have vaginal intercourse with you?
Yes.
Is that all?
No.
What else did he do?
He didn't really like to do vaginal, he just liked oral sex. And so, I gave him oral sex or whatever, and then...
Did he ask you to give him oral sex? Did he ejaculate?
Yes.
And then what happened?
Then after he busted in my face or whatever, then I had got up and I went to the bathroom. I ran up past the bathroom. I took a shower and then, I don't know where my sister was at that time, but she came back inside and she was like, "Why are you in the shower?" And then I told her, whatever, so I got to change the pants or whatever. That's when my parents had came.
Did you ever have any kind of sexual contact with once or twice before?
No.
Never?
No.
All right, that was the first time?
Yes.
And you told him at some point to stop?
Yes.
So your parents came to the house?
Yes.
That's Mr. Davis, your stepfather?
Yes.
And your mom?
Yes.
Was Quincy still there?
Yes.
Okay. Tell me about that.
So my, I had washed, like, when I came out or whatever, I had told my sister told me to make sure I washed my face or whatever. And not to tell my mom because my mom, she doesn't really believe us when we tell her people touch us or whatever. So she just said, don't tell my mom or anything. So my mom had got there. She came upstairs, and my stepdad came upstairs to get us because we're going to go to pick up my brothers and Barlow. And
let me just say, is the house there, they were saying, is that, that's the blue house?
Yes.
You said they came upstairs?
Yes.
Was there, maybe I misunderstood, was there an upstairs in that house?
Well, you have to walk upstairs to get to the door.
I see what you're saying. They just walked up the steps to come in. Okay, yes. Go, I'm sorry, go ahead.
So, that's when my mom, she went to the bathroom and she said she came out. She said she wasn't going, but we already knew what she was doing, so we just left.
Well, explain what you're talking about.
My mom did drugs a lot.
Okay.
So we already knew that she was doing drugs every day. She told us she doesn't want to go.
So she came into the house?
Yes.
Did your stepfather come into the house?
Yes.
Okay. After they came, when they came over, you were finishing up taking a shower, or you had already finished?
I had finished.
And where were you when they came?
I was in the hallway. Because I had washed my face and I walked out in the bathroom. Yeah, in the hallway.
Okay. Quincy Cross, where was he?
I think he was in Tamworth, so I'm not sure.
Where was Tamworth?
I don't remember.
She's still there?
Yes.
And your sister Brandy was there?
Yes.
Okay, so they came in to the house?
Yes.
And what happened?
And then my mom, she had went into the bathroom and she came back out, so she said she wasn't gonna go. So we already knew that she was drugs or whatever, so we just left.
Do you know what she did? Oh. While she was there?
Yes.
In the bathroom?
Yes.
Did she do it with anybody?
No, I didn't see anybody in the bathroom.
Okay. All right. So, you left? You all left the house?
Yes.
Who all left?
Myself, Brandy, and her dad, Curtis.
Okay. And your mom stayed?
Yes.
Okay, where'd you all go?
We went to go pick up my brothers. Not in Barlow.
You went to pick up your brothers in Barlow?
Yes.
And who was that?
Mario and Donald.
Okay, and where were they?
They were at my grandma's at the time.
I want you to walk. I want you to walk me through this whole period. Okay. All right. What time is it now when you all leave to go? Is it still morning or is it afternoon?
I think it's like the afternoon.
How long had you been? How long were you at Tamworth that morning? All right. So you left there. Through as much detail as you can.
We left there and went to go pick up. We didn't pick up our brothers right away because we always spent time with my grandma, whatever. And so my dad, my stepdad went to go do what he had to do, whatever. So we were just like, I was with my grandma and my sister visiting her cousins that were right there. And I was just talking to my grandma because my grandma knew that something was wrong, so I just went to my room and I was talking to my grandma. And I told my grandma, and she's like, did you tell your mom? And I was like,
you told your grandma what?
What happened.
With Quincy?
Yeah.
With Tamara?
Yes.
Okay.
And she's like, did you tell your mom? I was like, no. She said, that's a good thing. Like that. And then I hung out with my grandma. I helped her, like, cook, because she always cooked dinner, like, really early. And then that's when my dad came back and my brothers were walking across the field, my sister came back from her cousins.
Alright. And then what happened?
And then we went back to Mabel. And when we got back to Tamara's house, my mom was...
Is that where you went? To Tamara's?
Yeah.
From Barlow?
Yes.
Okay.
My mom was on...
Do you remember what time of the afternoon or evening it was?
I think it was like 4.
Okay.
And my mom was on the couch, she's like out of it or whatever. So we just left her there. And so myself, my brothers, and my sister, we left. Because my brothers had called earlier to the children's house to stay the night. So we just left. We could do whatever we want, so we just left or whatever.
Okay. Where'd your stepdad go?
I don't know. I think you stay there or we just
who left. Was it? Who was it Tamara's when you got back?
Just my mom.
She was by herself?
Yes.
All right. Then what happened?
So then we leave over to Joseph's house with my brothers and my sister and whatever.
Alright, so it's we're talking four-ish. Mm-hmm. Alright, and you go to Justin
Scholes' house.
Justin Scholes?
Yes.
Is that S-H-O-A-L-S?
I don't know how to spell that.
How do you say it?
Scholes.
Scholes. Alright. And it was you who all met? You?
My sister Brandy, my brother Mario, and my twin brother Donald.
Okay, you went over to Justin Scholes' house.
Yes.
And did you walk?
Yes.
And how far was that from Tamara's?
I don't know.
Do you know what street it's on?
No.
How long did it take you to walk, if you remember?
Maybe 10, 15 minutes.
Okay. And so you went over to Justin Scholes' house?
Yes.
What, do you remember what that house looked like?
It was white.
Was it a ranch or a two-story?
It was a
single. If you know.
It was a single-story house.
Okay. All right. And who was there when you got there?
Okay, so when we got there, we used to go into Justin's older brother's room to play the game, play the Sega. But when we go in there, there's Tamara, Q, this white guy, they call him Jeff or whatever, and
this white guy, they call him Jeff.
Yeah.
Okay.
And
do you remember what color hair he had?
No. And Billy and the baby.
Billy.
Lau and the baby.
Billy and Lau.
Yeah.
Is that L-Y-L-E? Lau?
Yeah.
And what baby?
Her baby.
Who's?
Billy's.
Okay. So Billy is a she?
Yes.
Okay. And what were they doing?
They were, I guess, talking because we left back out. And I was hanging by the door. It didn't have doors, so it had a curtain up. And so I was hanging like on the, I don't remember what side I was on, but where I was, we like to be nosy, so we're always listening in. The older kids always. And I just remember my cousin, she was crying. She said that, I asked her what's wrong and she said that.
Well, okay, they're in there talking.
Mm-hmm.
And you walk out.
Yes.
Okay. And was she crying while you were in there or after she came out?
After she came out.
Okay, so when you walked out, you were just sitting there listening to what they were saying?
Yeah. I was trying to mimic.
What were they saying?
I don't remember.
You don't remember what they were saying? Okay. Then what happened?
And then my cousin, she comes out.
By herself?
Yes, first she came out by herself.
Okay.
And I had asked her what's wrong, and she said that Quincy was going to kill someone. But he always said that all the time. You know, like, he said that. So you don't never take it serious. But then I don't remember telling
her. She's crying, and it seems kind of strange to me. She's crying, and he said that. So did you ask her who he was going to kill?
No.
Okay.
And so they left. I don't know at what point they left, but I remember that they left.
Who?
Quincy, Tamara, and the white guy, Jeff, and I don't think Billy left it. I don't remember.
Okay. So who was left there?
And myself, my sister had went next door to Laura's house, and my brothers and Justin.
Okay. Your brothers, Mario, Donald, your sister, Brandy?
Yes.
You and Justin.
Yes.
And you think Billy and the baby?
Yes. Yeah, I think they were sold out, but I don't remember.
Do you remember when Quincy and Tamara left? Do you remember how they went? Did they walk? Did they drive?
I don't know.
You don't know? No. Now, what time are we at? How long were you there, you think? How long are you at the Shoals house before they leave? Minutes? Hours?
I think like an hour or so, I'm not sure.
So, is this around supper time? I don't want to try to hold you to the times, but is it dark when they leave?
Getting there, not really dark.
Okay. This is July, so not the longest day of the year. It might not get dark till 8:30, 9 o'clock. Of course, you're on. It was in the evening?
Yes.
Somewhere. Now, let me ask you this. There is so you all then go to where? I'm sorry. After they leave, what do you all do?
We just play basketball. So just hang out.
How long were you there?
Late. Because my sister came around the door and told me that it was late and I needed to go home.
Brandy?
Yes, because she's next door at Laura's house.
Laura who?
Keely.
Keely? Mm-hmm. Okay, so it was you, Justin Shoals?
Yes.
Mario, Donald?
Yes.
And y'all playing video games? So, did y'all do any drugs of any kind?
No.
Did you drink?
No.
Nothing? You had no intoxicating substances that day?
No.
You sure?
Yes, I'm sure.
All right. When you say it was late, your best guess on what time it may have been? Was it before or after midnight? If you know.
I just know it was late.
Do you think it was after midnight? Before midnight? And if you can't say, then that's fine.
I don't know.
Think it was later than 10 o'clock?
Yeah, I know it was later because I always like watch things. So it was later.
So Randy comes over and tells you it's time to go home.
Yes.
And are your brothers going to go with you?
No, we're staying the night at Justin's house.
Okay. Okay, so. Now, do you know what street, did I ask you what street Justin Shoals is at?
Yes.
Do you know? So are you going to walk home?
Yes.
How far is the house? You're at the greenhouse then. Right?
Yeah.
How far is that house from the where Justin Shoals live? Walking.
This is like 10 minutes to walk home.
So you started walking home?
Yes.
You and Brandy?
Yes.
Can you tell me how you walked?
We walked through the back of the school.
What school?
Lakeville Middle School. Yeah.
You walk through the back of the school, behind the school.
Yes.
And you're walking toward where you all are staying.
Yes.
Tell me everything. I want you, what would be the best thing is if you can just walk me forward without me having to say anything.
So we're walking and then we had seen Venetia. She was on the stairs, or whatever, standing like on the stairs, and we were asking.
She was what on the stairs?
Standing. On the stairs or whatever, And we ask her, like, you know, what are you doing? She was just like, you know, just out walking or whatever, you know. Then we're like, okay, then we didn't really carry on a long conversation. We were like, okay, then we'll see you tomorrow or whatnot. So we left. I went home. We both went home, whatever. My sister went into the room. I was watching TV and my sister came back out of the room. Because we always stay up really, really late. And so that's when Tamar had knocked on her door. My sister answered, but she asked for me, for Victoria. And my sister said, okay, hold on. So she told me to come to the door, Tamar. And Tamar was like, oh, do you want to go for a ride? And I was like, okay, yeah, because she's older, I like to hang out with her. So then.
Yeah. Why would you go back out riding with Quincy after what he did to you that day? You know, that doesn't make a lot of sense to me. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
Why?
I don't know.
Were you afraid of Quincy at all?
Yeah.
Why did you get in the car with him?
I just want to hang out with my cousin.
So you go, are they driving a car at that point?
Yes.
What kind of car?
It was a white car.
You know what mountain make it was?
No.
You have no idea?
No.
Was it new, old?
It was old.
Okay. What color was it?
The car? It was white.
Okay. Did it, was it a hard top? Had a hard time, not convertible.
Oh, it was hard.
Okay. Was it all white? White roof, white sides, everything?
It was white, yes.
Okay. Was it a small, mid-size, or large vehicle? Was it just Tamara that came to the door?
Yes.
Okay. Did you ask who was with her?
No.
So she just asked you if you want to go for a ride?
Yes.
And you said?
Yes.
Okay.
And so then I get in the car, I got into the back seat, and the white guy was in the car, Jeff. Whatever, so we drove off, and then they went to go pick up Anisha or whatever.
Okay, you leave the house.
Yes.
Back out of it, drive with her, whatever. You start to drive. How do you know they were going to go get Anisha?
Well, I didn't until I seen her at the same place where I had seen her again. Okay.
So how long did it take you all to get to where Anisha was?
Not that long.
36, a minute and a half,
10. Maybe 3 or 4 minutes.
So you didn't drive around anywhere? You went straight to the middle school?
Yes.
Did anybody have a cell phone?
Not that I remember.
Do you know how they knew Manisha was there?
No.
So did you all just drive there and someone say, hey, there's Venetia, or how'd that happen?
No, they just pulled up and there's Venetia, and she just got in the car and I just screamed over it.
Okay. You're driving in the car. While you're driving in the car, does Jeff Burton try to put the moves on you at all?
No.
Not at all?
He was just weird. No.
Okay. Did anybody, were, as far as you can tell, was anybody drinking or high?
I think that my cousin was high.
What about Quincy?
I don't know.
What about Jeff Burke or Jeff?
Well, he was acting weird. I think he was acting weird.
Okay. All right, so you're driving along. What is it? What's anybody saying to you?
I remember we drove back, I don't remember, but we drove back to Christian or whatever.
I'm talking about before the Dick Vinnie show.
No, not really.
Was the radio on, stereo?
No.
No music playing?
No.
It was just the four of you all in the car?
Yes.
And you're driving? You know where you're going?
No.
And you're driving somewhere, and Venetia happens to be in there, and close by. Did you see her? What happened to cause you to stop? Or cause, who's driving the car?
Front seat.
Who else? Who's in the front seat?
Devin.
And you and Jeff Guy are in the back?
Yes.
Okay. What happened to cause you to stop?
I don't know. He just stopped. I don't know.
He just pulled up to where she was standing?
Yes.
Okay, then tell me about that.
Then they didn't talk, she just got in the car.
So there was no conversation whatsoever?
No.
Okay, and when she got in, what did they say? If anything?
Like, what's up? That's it.
Ask her if she wanted to go for a ride, or? So she just got in the car?
Yes.
Are y'all talking? Where is she in the car?
I scoot over to the middle.
She gets in.
Right.
So, is she on the driver's or passenger?
Passenger.
All right, so you're in the middle, and the guy named Jeff is on the driver's side back.
Yes.
All right. Then where do you go?
I remember Nisha had said that Jessica needed a ride or something like that. And Tamara and Quincy, they whispered something, but I didn't hear them. But then they drove out to Chris Drive, where all of them got out of the car except for me. They told me I couldn't get out of the car. And so they went inside. I don't know, I think it was like 10, 15 minutes, I'm not sure. And then they came back out and they just left. There.
So Venetia and Jeff and Tamara and Quincy went into Chris Drive?
Yes.
And do you know where on Chris Drive? Did you know who lived at the house?
No.
Did you know what they were doing in there?
No, but I just know there was a party.
So there was a party there.
Yes.
And you just sat in the back seat?
Yes.
By yourself?
Yes.
Yeah. All right. So they're in the house how long?
Maybe like 10, 15 minutes.
Okay. Then they came back out?
Yes.
All of them?
Yes.
Okay. And they get back in the car?
Yes.
In the same positions that before?
Yes.
All right, so Quincy's driving the car.
Yes.
Same car?
Yes. But when we drive, there's a big car that's following us.
Okay, so they get in the car. Do other people come out and get in the blue car?
I don't know. I just remember the blue car that was following us.
How do you know there was a blue car following
us? Because when I looked back, there was a blue car that was behind us.
Was it at the Chris Drive?
It was just following, that's all I remember.
Okay. Did anybody else come out? Was there a blue car at the Chris Drive house?
I don't know.
What's the significance to you of the blue car following you?
What do you mean?
Is there any significance to that? There was a blue car following?
Just keep going. Scott, you kind of.
Oh, okay. All right, so you all got back in the car and you started driving?
Yes. So we drive, and then we're driving, and then I think that's when they picked up Jessica.
Well, what were y'all doing in the car while you're driving?
I was just sitting back there. Tamara and Quincy. They were talking, but I don't know if they were saying.
So everybody's just sitting there saying nothing? Well, that doesn't sound like much fun to me. They're talking. What are you doing?
I'm just in the back seat. I'm just along for the ride.
Is Jeff hitting on you at all?
No.
Not at all?
No. He's acting weird.
What do you mean he's acting weird?
Because he likes to, like this, likes to look around a lot and stuff like that.
Yeah, okay. How long were y'all driving? So you're driving around?
Yes.
Go ahead.
We were driving around, and then that's when we saw Jessica and whatever. And
where did you see her?
I don't remember. The street or whatever.
And what was she doing?
She was walking.
Was she by herself?
Yes.
Do you remember what she had on?
No.
I have any idea. Pants, skirt, dress?
I think she had on pants.
Was she walking away from you or towards you? Car came up on her. You see her walk?
I'm trying to picture it.
What side of the car were you sitting on, Tori?
I was in the middle.
You was in the middle. Mm-hmm. When she came up to the car, who did she come up and talk to initially?
She was on Quincy's side.
So did he pull up beside her? Did he stop the car at some point?
Yes.
Was she standing there when he stopped the car?
No. She had to I think she walked around or something, I don't know.
Okay. She walked around where he was?
Yes.
Tell us what, if any, conversation you heard.
She wanted a ride home.
Did she ask for a ride home?
No. I think, if one is mentioned already, but I just remember wanting a ride home. That's it.
Okay. And did he say give her a ride?
I don't know. All
right. Did she get in the car?
Yes.
Okay. How did that happen?
He got in the car and then she got into the middle. And then
I know you've been asked this before, but the front seat of that car, was it two seats or was it a bench seat all the way across? Did she have to sit on a console or anything, or was
No, I think it was up or whatever. I think that was in the console.
But there was a seat up there where she could sit, if you remember?
I think so.
Okay. But she was sitting in the middle.
Yes.
Did she seem like she was in a good mood?
She seemed okay.
Is anybody acting fun at this point to you?
They're rubbing her legs.
I'm talking about when. When you look back on this, Victoria, is anybody, can you see what's going to happen here at all? You can't see, you have no, at this point, you have no. All right, we're back on the record at 6:35 after a short break. All right, Victoria, you were at the point where you were telling us that Jessica Curran had just gotten in the car. She got in the middle of the front seat between Tamara Caldwell and Quincy Cross.
Yes.
And now she just walked me through what happened from now on.
Okay, so she gets in the car. We start driving. And I remember Tamara was rubbing this up, her right, I think that's her right side, because it was almost like, but she pushed her hands away or whatever, and that's when Quincy got angry.
So they were rubbing on her?
Mm-hmm.
Now, is Tamara, is she bisexual?
Yes.
Did you know she was bisexual?
Yes.
And had you ever had any sexual contact with her?
No.
So they start rubbing on Jessica and she pushes their hand away. Do you remember what, if anything, she said?
I think she said stop.
Okay. And then what happened?
And then he got angry. And then we...
How do you know he got angry?
Because he was like swearing.
What was he saying?
Bitch this. Which Donald just kept on beating a lot.
Was he talking to Jessica?
Yes.
So he was calling her a bitch?
Yes.
Because what? Because she wouldn't let him touch her?
Yes.
Okay. What was anybody else saying anything?
No. I was just like staring at them, whatever.
So, what did y'all do?
We were driving, and then...
How long were you driving?
I don't know, a couple minutes.
Just a couple minutes?
Yes.
Okay.
And then we drove, and we stopped at the white guy's house. Or
how did you know it was the white guy's house?
Not until we got inside, because he opened the door.
Okay. Had you ever been to that house before?
Yes.
You have been there?
Yes.
More than once?
Yes.
What were you doing over at his house?
My sister used to mess with me.
Your sister?
Yeah.
Which one?
Rosie.
Okay, so you knew him? Because your sister used to mess with him?
Yeah, I get high there.
Okay, and you don't know his last name?
I think it's like, I thought it was like Burton Burton or something.
Say again?
Burton or Burton, something like that.
Burton? Okay. Do you have a hard time saying that name?
Yes.
Why?
I don't know.
Why do you always refer to him as a white guy named? If you know his name, what's so hard about saying his name?
I don't know. I've heard people like that.
Okay. So, before this, your sister, Rosie, dated him or messed around with him?
Yes.
And you were there with her before and him?
Yes.
And other people?
Yes.
Few or many times?
A lot of times.
So you've been there a number of times, to his house.
Yes.
Okay. Now, where did your sister Rosie live?
I think it was West End. That's where she lived.
So she didn't live in Mayfield?
No.
So how would you happen to be at his house with your sister Rosie?
Because my cousin does her hair, so she would come up because Tamara would do her hair and stuff like that.
And you would find yourself over at Jeff Burton's house with your sister Rosie.
Yes.
Did you do any drugs at all?
No.
Tamara?
No.
None at all? You never smoked pot?
I have before, but not with them.
Had you smoked pot at that time?
What do you mean?
Well, when you were 15 at this time, had you smoked pot before? Had you tried it?
No.
So at this point in time, you had never smoked pot?
Never.
And you haven't had anything to drink or any other drugs that day at all? Nothing
to
drink?
They wanted me to do a line of coke, but I didn't do it.
They wanted you to do a line of coke where?
At Jeff's house.
Okay. So you all pull up to Jeff's house, and you've already, as I understand it, you've gone to Mayfield with Agent O'Neill and Agent Wise and Commissioner James, and you have identified where that house was, right?
Yes.
Is it there now?
No.
Okay. Is there anything there?
Just, I don't know what it's called, but there's nothing up there somewhere.
The house is not there anymore?
No.
Has it been torn down?
Yes.
All right.
The foundation there with rocks, part of the foundation is still present in the back of the house. And what I've done is I want you to share that. That's for your viewing right there.
Okay. Can you identify that house?
It's probably going to be Victoria when the house was a lot newer. So.
Right.
I mean, it's not going to look exactly like you probably remember.
But
I think the helper stat would be more, she knew how the room, she's already articulated how the rooms were set up. We could see if that was close to.
Do you remember what side the driveway was on, Victoria, by looking at that picture right there?
Does this house look familiar to you? You can say whether it does or not.
It's in black and white, you know, it's not in color. How many stairs in front of the house? Is that the same?
There is three steps.
Okay. You pulled up to this house. And you know for a fact that the house that you pulled up to, Jessica and Quincy Cross and Manisha and Tamara and this Jeff guy, was his house.
Yes.
And you have been there before.
Yes.
And so, did you go into the house?
Yes.
Front or back?
The front.
Did the house have a driveway?
Yes.
Was the driveway in right, left, or center of the house? You pulled up to the house. If you remember.
I think it was off to the left of the house.
Okay. Was it nighttime when you got there?
Yes.
Was this? You think it was after midnight?
Yes.
Okay. Do you remember what color the house was? Let me ask you, do you remember if it was brick or something else?
It wasn't brick.
So was it white? Yeah, I'm just going to go back to this picture. Does this picture do anything for you? Is it possible that this is the house that Jeff Burton lived in? And from your memory?
I think so.
Okay. And why do you think so? How many times do you think you've been there?
Maybe six times.
Okay. Had you ever been there during the day?
No, we only go at night.
Only go at night?
Yeah, because Dad's not there.
So the only time you ever went to the house was at night?
Mm-hmm. Yes.
Okay. Can you say for certain whether that's the house that you were, where you pulled up to that night? I'm looking at that picture. Is it possible? Let me ask you this, okay? If the lot where this house was, okay, did you take Agent O'Neill and Agent Wise to where that house was yesterday on Sunday?
Yes.
You took them to where that house used to be.
Yes.
And it's did you all go by there?
Yes.
Okay. Were you able to take them to where that house? The house that you went with Quincy Cross and Jessica Curran and Tamara Caldwell and Jeff, the white guy named Jeff Burton, and Venetia, were you able to take them to where that house was when you went to Mayfield just yesterday? Did they take you to? Was that one of the places that you all were trying to identify?
Yes.
Did they take you?
Yes.
Okay. Were you able to know where that house was?
Yes.
You were? You're sure?
Yes.
Okay. Was there a house there?
When we got there?
When you got there?
No.
Okay. And when were you there?
Yesterday.
Okay, today is Monday. You were there yesterday, Sunday.
Yes.
All right, now let me put it to you this way. This is from the Property Valuation Administrator's Office in Maiden Grays County, and it identifies the mail address as 214 West Center Street. Okay? If this is the lot where this house was, and this is the lot that you identified where you were that night, do you have any reason to believe this isn't the house?
No.
Do you know what the address was when you went that night? Do you know what street it was on?
I remember it because he's hitting down the street from the house.
What was the street?
Which street?
Where Jeff Burton lived.
On Center Street.
It was on Center Street.
Yes.
All right. So he lived on Center Street.
Yes.
All right. If this is where he lived on Center Street, and this is the lot where that house used to be, you tell me, did you or did you not identify the place where Jeff Burton, his house used to be?
Yes.
And where you all were that night?
Yes.
And you identified the place where it was and there was no house there?
Yes.
And if where you identified is where that house sits right there in that picture, then this was the house. Is that fair? You understand what I'm asking?
Yes.
All right. When you all drove by yesterday, you pulled up in front of it or in a driveway or whatever, okay. Did you know immediately where you were?
Yes.
Okay. No question. All right. And you said that's where the house was. Is that right? Yes or no?
Yes.
You're having trouble. What's wrong?
First of all, when we pulled up by the house, we drove by the house the first time, and I noticed her composure was dipping a little bit. Anxiety was setting in, so I made a phone call and I acquired the true address, the 214, and going past, making another pass, and pulling into the bunch of the foundation where the driveway still exists at 215 and 214 Center Street. Victoria then identified the property as being the house where Jeff Burton did reside, and she kind of supported her own statement by following up and telling us that maybe a month and a half ago, she had received a phone call from her sister, Rosie Christ. And Rosie Christ advised her that she had been in contact with Jeff Burton over the phone, and he had asked her to have Victoria not identify that property.
Is that why we're having trouble here? You tell me.
Yes.
You sure? Is that why you keep looking at that picture? Because you don't want to say, I mean, is there any question in your mind, Victoria, look at me. Is there any question in your mind whether that is the house, honestly, that you were in that night? It is. And what? Why are you having so much trouble telling me that? Still.
I can remember the house.
Because you were looking at it for a long time. I want to know. I need to know. I need to know. Okay? If it wasn't that house, then you need to tell me now. I don't want another day to come and you say, oh, no, I wasn't that house. Is that the house?
Yes.
All right. No question in your mind. And the reason you're hesitating was because, why?
I don't like to remember.
You don't like to remember. Are you afraid based on what your sister said to you? Combination of all those things?
Yes.
Okay. So you all pull up to that house. What's going on in the car when you pull up?
Well, before I pulled up, I remember, like, right before we went to go turn to the driveway,
who's he?
Quincy. He hit her with a bat in her head.
A bat? Kind of bat?
Like a little bat.
Okay. How'd you know it was a bat?
Because I seen it when he pulled it from below, like under him or something.
Okay.
And he hit her with it.
Where'd he hit her?
Back here.
What'd she do?
She went unconscious.
Huh?
She went unconscious.
She went unconscious. So she was out.
Yes.
Okay.
And then they went to get out of the car, and they had her by her arms or whatever. And then they took her into the house with Tamar and Quincy.
What did the three of you do?
We just followed behind.
All three of you?
Yes.
Who opened the door?
Yeah, they.
So he was in front?
Not until when we all had got up, then he opened the door.
Was it the house locked?
I can't remember.
Was there anyone else there?
No.
Were there any lights on?
I think the living light was on, I'm not sure. Okay.
And Jessica Kern is not conscious?
No.
She's just limp?
Yes.
Okay.
So then we get into the house.
Now here's where I want to tell you something. At this point on, as much as you don't want to talk about it, as much as you don't want, I don't want you to minimize anything that you did or saw. Okay, from the background on, it's really important. I promise you, I'm not going to think any less of you. I'm either Bob or Lee or Commissioner James. I want you to be as open with me as you can, as hard as it is for you to talk, but I want you to tell me exactly what happened when y'all go in.
Okay, so
me,
Quincy and Howard, they took her to the bedroom, and they laid her on the bed, and then...
How do you know?
Because I saw them lay her on the bed.
Okay.
Then I went back to the living room.
You saw them lay her on the bed?
Yes.
And as soon as you saw them lay on the bed, did you leave?
No.
Okay, what did you tell me?
Then I went back into the living room and can't think of like where everybody was, but I don't keep in time was in the room. And
was the door to the bedroom open or shut?
No, it's not shut all the way, but it's cracked just a little.
Okay.
And so then I just remember her, like, saying something about her son. She woke up, whatever, and she was saying something about her son. William.
Was she knocked out cold?
What do you mean?
Well, you said she was unconscious. I mean, was she completely unconscious when you took her in the house? When they took her in? Or was she?
She was just unconscious.
Completely out. Like this?
She was, I don't know, her feet were dangling when they were taking her inside.
Was she making any sounds?
Not that I remember.
And you saw them take her in there. Where was Jeff Burton?
I can't remember exactly where he was.
Okay.
And then they went to bed and then I came back out. Remember? Then I went into the living room.
So you went into the bedroom?
Yes.
Why? You don't know why?
I just went in there.
What were you doing in there?
I just looked at what they were doing.
What were they doing?
They laid her on the bed, and then I left back out.
What were they saying, if anything?
I don't remember.
Were they saying anything?
I don't remember.
Were they talking to each other?
I don't remember.
Were they saying anything to her?
I don't
Did
remember.
You hear that her say anything to them?
I don't remember.
When they laid her down, was she awake?
No.
Were her eyes open or closed? So, you left the room. Mm-hmm.
Then I remember hearing like yelling, so I was wondering what the hell was going on, so I went back in. And she was saying something about her son. And
who was saying something?
Jessica. About
so
her
she
son.
Was awake?
Yeah.
Okay. Now, you walk back in the room.
Yes.
Who was in the room when you walked back in?
Quincy, Tamara. Manisha, I went in, but she came back out, whatever. And I think that's it.
You think that's it? You sure? Where's Jeff?
I don't remember.
Is he in the room?
Victor, what did Jeff do to Jessica?
He had sex with her.
Yeah.
When I couldn't see her at the back.
Okay, well, let's back up on that. Let's see. You walked into the bedroom. This is when you first got there.
Yes.
You walked in with them.
Yes.
As they're carrying her in.
Yes.
Just curious.
Yes.
And they laid her on the bed. Was she facing up or down?
She was on her back.
On her back. Is her head toward the front of the head of the board, headboard? Did the bed have a headboard on it? It was just a mattress, if you remember. If you walked into the bedroom, where was the bed located? Walk me into that house, okay, and tell me how you got to the bedroom.
We walked in, and I think we went back to the left.
Okay.
So we walk in and we went back to the left.
Okay.
And their bedroom and their door wasn't open.
Is the room on the left or right?
It's on the left.
Alright. Is it that room? On the front of the house?
Yes.
It is?
Yes.
Okay, so they're carrying her in, and you follow them.
Yes.
And you walk into the room with them.
Yes.
And you don't remember what, if anything, was being said. Did he throw her on the bed? Lay her on the bed?
Like, drop her on the bed?
How did he put her on the bed?
They got her up to the bed and just.
Okay. Do you remember whether she was awake at this point? She seemed like she was awake? Or asleep? I know you don't want to think about this. But was she awake or was she asleep? Was she knocked out when they laid her on that bed?
No.
Yeah.
She wasn't knocked out. She was like, you know, like, kind of like groaning, kind of like.
Right.
That's what she was doing. Where her eyes were closed.
Do you remember what, if anything, anyone said when they put her on the bed?
No.
And did you see them do anything to her? So they're in the room, and you walked out, and you went where?
I went back to the room.
What are you doing in the room?
Just like pacing.
Pacing. Okay. Where's Jeff?
He went into the room.
He went into the room. Are you pacing by yourself? Where's Venetia?
She was like off to the left of me.
What's she doing?
Just there.
Are you all talking to each other? Saying anything?
No. We looked at each other, but we didn't say nothing. Okay. Then what? Then, like, I heard her yelling when I went back into the room. Because I wanted to know what was going on, so I went back to the room. And I think she was, like, lifting up or whatever, and he hit her in the back of the head, and then she went back out again. Like, knocked out.
You saw him hit her?
Yes.
Okay, who was in the room at that point?
It was myself, Tyler, Lindsay, and I think Jeff was in there, but I don't remember.
She had been in there?
Yes.
So was he in there when they went in to drop her on the bed?
To push the door.
Did he stay in there?
No. Everybody kind of, well, not much of the time, but everybody kind of, like, between, like, me and each other, Jeff, we kind of, like, went in and out there.
All right. So you went back in the room. And when you went back in the room, Tamara and Quincy, and you don't know if Jeff was in there or not.
The second time?
The second time. you see when you went back in the room?
Tamara was holding her legs, and Quincy was over her.
What do you mean he was over her?
He was like...
Was he sitting on her?
No, his butt wasn't all the way on her, but he was like over her.
Yeah, what, did he have pants on?
Yeah, he did have pants.
Okay. Could you see what he was doing?
He, like, had, like, the belt, like, around her neck or whatever.
When you say the belt, what do you mean, the belt?
His belt.
How do you know it was the belt?
Because his belt wasn't on him. And he had a black leather belt on him.
And you knew what color it was?
Yes.
How did you notice that he had a black belt?
Because he was...
I mean, there's been a lot of talk about a black belt and all this, Victoria. And you knew, you're saying that he had a belt around her neck.
Yes.
And it was his belt.
Yes.
And you knew he had a black belt.
Yes.
Because you had seen him wearing a black belt.
Yes.
How did you see him wearing a black belt? How could you, at what point in that day did you notice that he had a black belt?
I just seen it that night.
I'm sorry?
That night. That everything happened. That's when I seen it, like he kind of, like, leaned up.
And he leaned up again.
Like, to, like, go, like, I don't know, he was just, like, leaning over, whatever, like, upwards.
What was he doing? What was he doing? What was he doing?
I don't know.
You don't have any idea? Any? Okay, you're losing me. You're saying that's the first time you noticed the belt?
Yes.
You saw him take, did you see him take the belt off?
No. But I remember when he was over here, he didn't have the belt on.
How did you know it was his belt?
Because he didn't have his on.
How do you know it was his? Do you know for a fact that belt was his? Why do you say it was his belt?
Because he didn't have his belt on.
I understand that, but how do you know he had a belt on?
Because I seen him when he was leaning over.
When he was leaning over. When?
Like, when they were...
You've explained to me that you took him, that you walked into the room when they laid her down. And then you left.
Yes.
Did you know he had a belt on then?
Before then, I did.
Huh?
Before then, yes.
Before then, you knew he had a belt on.
Yes, because he was like, he was leaning over. I don't know if he was, I don't know. But he was leaning over. I can't remember what he was doing, but he was leaning over.
Okay. You're in the car with him. Do you know he has a belt on then? Did you know he had a belt on when y'all were sitting in the car?
No.
You did. Okay, back on the record at 7:10. All right. Now, you just told me before we changed discs that you did not know that he had a belt, whether he had a belt on or not, before you got out of the car.
Yes.
Is that correct?
Yes.
All right. You've told me that he and Tamara took Jessica into the house and into a bedroom and laid her on a bed.
Yes.
And then you told me you left.
Yes.
Then the next thing you said was you went in back into the room and he had a belt around her neck. Is that right?
Yes.
How do you, at what point you, how do you know it was his belt?
Because he had a belt on it, it wasn't there.
When did you notice he had a belt on? How did you know he had a belt on? Are you assuming he had a belt on? Are you assuming that it was his belt?
I know he had that black belt on.
Okay. And how do you know that? Why do you know that?
He was like leaning over.
He's leaning over her. Did you see him take the belt off and put it around her neck?
No.
You sure? You positive?
Yes.
You didn't see that? You did not see him take his belt off and wrap it around her neck?
No.
Then how do you know it was his?
Because he didn't have his belt on anymore.
When did you see it on him?
When he was leaning over.
When was that? When did you see him when he was leaning over? The second time you went in?
It was the first time.
The first time, when they laid her on the bed. Okay. It's okay. Take your time. My understanding was that you went in and they laid her on the bed and then you left. Is that the way it happened? You went in there, they laid her down. You remember walking into that room behind them as they're taking her in?
Yes.
And you saw them lay her down?
Yes.
And my understanding was you left. But what you're telling me now is you didn't leave. Didn't leave right away. Okay. So, when you went in the room there, when they laid her on the bed, is that when you saw Quincy had a belt on?
Yes.
Okay. And how did you know he had a belt?
Because he was leaning over
her. Okay. He was leaning over her. Was he over top of her? Was he on the bed?
He was.
Was he on the bed?
Like.
Was he on the bed?
Yeah, a little bit. Like with one knee.
What was he doing?
He has private party.
Okay. What was he doing? Is that when you saw the belt?
Yes.
Okay, now let's see him. Where are you?
I'm kind of by the door, but like against the wall.
So you walk in the front door, turn to the left, mm-hmm. And there's a bedroom on the left.
Yes.
All right, where's the bed?
I think it's like...
Let's do it like this. Let's say this is the front door. And you walk in, and then somehow, let's say there's a hallway here, and like a doorway here, you go into a room. On the front of the house, you walk in the front door, you go in here somewhere and there's a hallway, or you turn to the left somehow. You walked in that front door right there.
Yes.
You walked in. You said the bedroom was to the left.
Yes.
Was there a hall you walked down? Or was it just you walked in and the doorway to the bedroom was right there?
Did you have to go through the sitting area to get to that bedroom?
Yes.
All right. So let's just say you walk into the bedroom. Is the door on the middle of the wall in the bedroom? On one end of the bedroom?
No.
When you walk in the door, what are you looking at?
the bed.
Is it up against the wall by the door? Is it over up in the other corner? Is it to the right?
I think it's like...
in the center?
I think it's kind of like...
Let's just say this is the ring here. This is a square, okay? Where do you think the bed is? Where's the door right here? You put the door... you show me where the door is.
It's here.
Okay, this is the door. Now, where's the bed?
Here. Look right here.
Draw it.
Look
right here. Is it up against the wall? Take her in. Are you in front or behind?
I'm behind.
All right. So they take her and they put her on the bed.
Yes.
Now where's Tamara and where's Quincy?
Tamara is over here.
Okay.
Quincy's over here.
All right. So as you face the bed, Tamara's on the right, Quincy's on the left.
Yes.
What does he do? Anything.
He, like, he's kind of put her onto the bed. And then he like put his, I think it was his right knee onto like the side of the bed. And her head, she like turned her head like this to the side.
Toward him?
Mm-hmm.
Okay.
And then he just took his pants down or pulled his pants down.
Is that when you noticed he hit a bell?
Yeah.
Did you see him undo the bell?
Yeah, he like undid it and just like was right off his dark.
Was he saying anything to Jessica?
No.
Was he saying anything to Tamara?
Do you like him?
That's what Quincy said to Tamara.
Yes.
What'd she say? Watching for a minute?
No, I just remember him just pulling his primary out, and then he was just like, maybe I was in it for like maybe like 5 seconds and he did it. And then I let that go. Well, I asked her if she liked it, and I let that go.
Okay. So when you went back in, how long were you out of the room, if you can remember? But you went back in?
Yes.
And you went back in, why?
Because I heard yelling.
What kind of, what'd you hear?
Like, she was yelling about her son.
Who was yelling?
Jessica.
How do you know she was yelling about her son?
Because... Zion.
Did you know who Jessica's boy? Did you know she had a child?
I knew she had a child.
Did you know what his name was?
Yes.
Had you seen him before?
Like once or twice, yeah.
What was she saying?
Like, remember I had a son. And she just kept saying Zion.
Was she yelling, crying, screaming? What was she doing?
She was yelling.
Was she crying?
I don't remember.
Was she begging?
Then what happened?
Then she like...
Did you go back in the room? You did. All right. Now, when you went back in the room, can you see yourself going back in?
Yes.
You can see it? You see yourself walking back in there?
Yes.
Who's in there?
Taylor, Lindsay, myself, and I think Jeff is there, but I can't, like, really call.
Okay. When you go back in there, what's going on? What did you see?
Tamara was holding her legs, and he was over her.
Okay. Where is Tamara when you go back?
She's here.
Is she on the bed?
No, she's like...
Is she going around to the other side now?
I don't remember. I just know she was holding her legs.
Where was she holding her leg?
Here.
On her thighs?
Yeah.
Around her knees?
Yeah, right here.
Okay. Was she kicking her legs? Was she trying to get away?
I remember. I just remember they were holding. She was holding her legs.
Well, did you see her fighting to get away? Why was she holding her legs down? What was she doing? Just holding them? That's all she was doing.
Yes.
Did Jessica have any clothing on?
No.
None?
I think she had her shirt on, but I know she didn't have nothing on at the bottom.
And how do you know that?
Because I seen her.
You could see her.
Was
Tamara performing oral sex on her?
No.
She was not. Are you sure?
I didn't see her yet.
What did you hear them say anything when you walked in there?
No, I just told them that I went to me, and they just said I'm in it just as much as they are now.
Well, you walk in the room, and Tamara's holding your legs down. Okay? Where's Quincy?
He's over.
So is his back to you? Is he on the bed?
Yes.
If she's laying here, is he like on top of her? Facing her head?
Yes.
Okay. Did he have his pants on? Did you walk into the room?
Yes.
Where'd you go?
Right here. By the wall. I was kind of on the wall.
What'd you see?
I saw a Tamara holding her legs, and I saw Quincy with the belt on his hand.
Which hand did he have it in?
His right hand.
His right hand. So, if he's over here, he's got it in this hand?
Yes.
Okay. And what's he doing?
He's like,
what's she doing? What's Jessica doing?
That's when...
What's Jessica doing while he's pulling away the bell?
Gasping
for air. Is he saying anything to Jessica?
Die, bitch, die.
Die, bitch, die. Is he doing anything to her? Did you see his penis in her mouth?
No.
Did you see him? Did you see his penis out?
No.
But you don't think he had pants on. Do you know if, could you tell if he had ejaculated?
No.
You couldn't tell?
No.
Okay. What are you saying?
I found that lines are weak.
Well, how are you saying it? Are you freaking out? Or
yeah.
Are you screaming? Or are you?
I'm yelling and telling them I want to leave. And they said, no, I'm
who in said, it. Who said?
Both of them said I'm in it just as much as they are.
Okay. So what are you doing?
Crying.
Okay, and what? He's choking. She's gasping. You're seeing this.
Yes.
What else happens? What else do you see?
Then I think that's when Jeff had came in the room. And he had sex with her.
Is she alive?
I don't think so.
What makes you think that? Where was Quincy when he did that?
Like still by her head, just standing.
Is he on the bed?
No.
Beside the bed. Okay. So. Jeff comes in the room?
Yes.
Where are you?
I'm still in there because I can't leave now.
Okay. And he just walks in the room?
Yes.
And what is it? How does it happen? How does he?
They said it's your turn.
Who said it's your turn?
Quincy said it's your turn.
Okay.
And so.
And you told me, you said a little earlier that she tried to raise up and he hit her again. When was that?
That was what she was saying to her son.
The second time he went back in?
Yes. When he was like,
Did you see him hit her in the head when she had one of the bells around her neck? Did you see him hit her in the head in the bedroom?
Yes.
Was she alive at that point?
Yeah, she was.
How do you know she was?
Because she was kind of like lifting up or whatever.
She was trying to lift up?
Yes.
And where was the bed?
I think it was on the floor or something.
Okay. You saw him hit her with it?
Yes.
Where did he hit her, if you remember?
I think when she lifted up, he just... I don't know if it was... I'm thinking that it was a sight.
He hit her in the head?
Yes.
Somewhere in the head?
Yes.
Okay. Did you ever notice any blood on her face? So you say this Jeff Burton guy comes in and Quincy says it's your turn.
Yes.
What's Burton do?
He takes off his pants and he has sex with
her. Okay. Is she moving? And not at all.
Yeah.
Is he saying anything? Or is anybody saying anything?
Just laughing.
Who's laughing?
All of them.
Where's Venetia?
She comes in but she leaves right back out.
So did he ejaculate? Did he have intercourse with her?
Yes.
And did you ever see her move?
No.
Never saw her move? And she never said anything while he's doing that?
Victor, do you recall seeing him put on any protection? Rubber, plastics, rubbers?
No.
Okay. So he had sex with her. And you don't know whether he ejaculated or not?
No.
How long does that last?
I don't know.
But you're still there?
Yes.
Okay. And they're laughing. Did he act like you got off at some point?
Not
really. Is anybody holding her down, holding her arms or anything while he's doing that? Where's Tamara?
She's still on the right side of the bed.
What's she doing?
Laughing.
She. Did you ever see her touch Jessica?
No.
And after Jeff Burton has intercourse with her, what happened?
Then I remember like a couple minutes passed and I just remember that I just kept looking in. I remember as a kid my mom taught me like if you could see like the breathing going up and down on her, and I just remember I just wanted to go touch her neck. She said she had a pulse and she didn't have a pulse.
You just went to go over and touch her neck?
Yes.
Where was everybody else then?
They're just like by the dresser.
Doing what?
I don't know. They were just standing by the dresser.
All three of them?
Yes.
What are they doing?
I don't know. Their backs are toward me.
What do you think they're doing? What are they doing over there?
They're getting high.
Is that when they ask you to get high? Had you seen them do any coke before that?
No.
Who got the coke out, if you remember?
Lindsay.
Did you see him put it out on the dresser?
Yes.
Okay. And did you see them doing it?
Yes.
Did they all three do it?
Yes.
Did they ask you to do it?
Yes.
Okay. And you did?
No.
Did Venetia do it?
I don't think so.
Okay. So when they go over to the dresser, you go over and feel her neck?
Yes.
Okay.
And that's when I just said she's dead.
Okay. So how did they do more than one line of coke?
I don't remember.
You just saw them dead?
Yes.
Then what?
Then they didn't like wrap her up like right away into the blanket.
Right.
They just
tell me exactly what happened. You are in the room.
They were just like they were talking.
What were they saying?
That it's over. And then
they said it's over?
What? I don't know what they're talking about.
Okay.
And I just remember them just wrapping her and Lindsay gave me the white rope to tie at the bottom.
Okay. All right, so they get done, and then they go over and do some coke.
Yeah.
And you go over and feel her neck.
Yes.
And you say she's dead.
Yes.
Then what?
They didn't wrap her all the way. I remember my cousin. She got the camera off the dresser.
The camera off the dresser?
The camera.
What camera?
The camera that just, which had just come out.
Whose camera was it?
I don't know.
Did somebody bring a camera in?
No, I didn't see anybody with the camera.
There just happened to be one on the dresser?
Yes.
And it just happened to have film in it?
Yes.
Okay. So who got the camera?
Tamara.
Okay.
And
what did they say, if anything?
They just started taking pictures.
Okay, tell me, what were they doing?
Lindsay had his private part out over her mouth.
Whose mouth? Jessica's. Did he put it in her mouth?
I don't remember.
Did he lay it on her face?
Like, on her lips.
Okay.
And they were taking pictures. And then, I remember them snapping a picture of her breast in her private area.
Were they doing anything to her when they were taking the pictures?
Just like, pulling her legs open to snap the picture.
Okay. Were they touching her? Victoria, did anybody act like they were performing oral sex on her?
Who? Yes, my cousin.
Your cousin. Okay. Did she? Was she doing it?
Mm-hmm.
You don't know? Did they ask you to do it? Did they ask you to do it? Is there a picture somewhere where you're doing?
No.
You sure?
Yes.
There's not a picture somewhere? You're positive?
I'm positive.
So what'd you say?
I said no.
What about Venetia?
She was being
See, I think that you did, and I don't think you can admit it. I think that's my opinion. I think right here as we sit here, you realize how sick that is, and I don't think you can admit that you do that. That's what I think.
I didn't do it.
All right. How many pictures did they take?
The whole row, I think.
Did you look at the pictures?
When we had the meeting, that's the only time.
So they took pictures. And then what happened?
Then they set the camera down. And then I remember they wrapped her into the blanket.
Was there any discussion about anything?
Just to
wrap her. Victoria, how did you come to tear? Were you how did you get picked to do that? How did that occur?
What I'm trying to get you to do, Victoria, is I'm trying to get you to tell me as much as you can about what's going on in there. Who's saying? You know what I'm saying? How's this? They take these pictures and then tell me how this.
Well, they're getting off on this stuff, are they partying, are they jumping, they laughing? What are they doing in the room while the pictures are being taken?
They're laughing.
What are they saying?
What are they saying while Venetia is putting, she put her fingers inside of Jessica?
Yes.
What are they saying?
Does it feel good?
Is she alive at that point?
Is her eyes open?
No, shut up.
Okay. So, Lee, did you see anybody get off while ejaculate or have an orgasm?
No.
All right. tell me what occurs, what if anything is said. Who said wrapper in the blanket? Okay. So tell me what happened.
They wrap onto the blanket.
Who wrapped her in the blanket?
Quincy, Cameron, and Jeff.
Did you help?
Tyler. Wow.
Okay. So what's Venetia?
She was just standing there watching.
So was the blanket on the bed? Whose idea was to tie the light?
Quincy just told me to tie the light.
That's what?
From my rope.
Where did it come from?
I don't know, he just gave it to me.
Did it just appear? You just happened to have a white rope?
I don't know, he just gave it to me.
Okay, so you tied it. Okay. Was she all the way inside the blanket? Tie the top?
No.
And what?
And then they tower and once they picked up the body. And they walk to the back and they put it in the trunk.
How'd the car get around that? Was that where the car was?
No, not at first.
Did somebody bring the car around that? When you got out of the car, where was the car?
It was in the
front. Did somebody bring the car around back?
I don't remember.
Did it just drive by itself? Was it back there at some point?
Just when they took the money off.
So the car was in the back. Yeah. Is it the same car that you were in before?
Yes.
Okay. The white car?
Yes.
Was it backed up to the door? Who drove the car around back?
I don't know.
You have no idea?
No.
Was it you?
No.
Did somebody leave the room? At some point?
I was not to go to the room the last time it's vacation, so.
But we're back on and it's 7:53 after a short break. Now, I want to go back to the bedroom. I want to go back to what occurred in that house after Jessica was taken into the house. Is there anything else we need to know? Okay. Well, this is the time to tell it. What is it?
I kissed her on her lips. I kissed her on her breast. And then
were there pictures of it? how long did this all go on after she after she died?
Like an hour.
An hour? Did anybody else have sex with her? Intercourse?
No, but my cousin Cameron had took her cast out that she had on him. They had to put her where they made her hand touch my cousin's private area.
They made Jessica's hand? Did they do anything with her hand?
Just like make her just touch her.
Did they insert her fingers or into her? Did anybody have, did either Tamara or you or Quincy or Jeff have sex with each other? Any of you all there together? Perform oral sex on Anisha?
Yes.
Did she perform oral sex on you?
Yep.
Where were you when that happened?
Around the floor.
Did anybody else have any sexual conduct? Contact? Other people?
Quincy had sex. And Jeff was there with them.
Where was that?
On the floor.
Did someone take pictures of that?
Yes.
Did you take some pictures? What did you take pictures of?
Quincy and Jeff.
And where was Jessica at this time?
Still.
Was the belt still around her neck?
Yes.
Did you see when Jessica took her last breath? Tell me about that. So you all had this, there was a lot of, there was sexual activity going on for about an hour. And you're saying you didn't take any of that cocaine. Did you take cocaine that night? So you did this completely, not under the influence of anything.
No, they gave me an e-pill.
A what?
An e-pill.
What's that?
Ecstasy.
What was that? When did they give you the ecstasy?
Like, when they were in the coach.
Well, did anybody else take ecstasy?
I don't think you should take.
Who gave you the ecstasy? And you're sure it was after Jesse was dead?
Yes.
You're positive?
Yes.
But you didn't do any cocaine, Victoria?
I did it because it burned my nose.
Victoria?
I did it just...
It burnt your nose. Now, a little while ago, I asked you if you had any drugs before this, and you said no. Now you're telling me that you didn't because it burnt your nose, which only makes me know that before you've snorted cocaine, or otherwise you wouldn't know it burnt your nose. Why is it that you're having such a hard time coming out with this stuff? I don't understand. How many times are we going to have to talk before? How many times are you going to have to give this account before you tell the truth? That's what I'm trying to figure out. I don't understand.
Because I don't
I mean, there's nothing that you can say that's going to be any worse than what's going on here. There's an 18-year-old girl who was murdered that night, and snorting some cocaine is the least of the bad that went on that evening. I can tell you that. I got to know these things.
I did try it, but it burned my nose.
When?
When they were at the dresser, after I said to them that she was dead.
Not before.
Yeah.
Nobody did any coke before.
Yeah.
You're sure?
Yes.
You didn't do it in the car?
No.
You're hesitating.
I didn't do it in the car.
Did they do it in the car?
Yes.
So we're driving around doing coke. Right?
Yes.
And you're telling me you didn't try it in the car?
No.
You did not try it?
No.
You're sure?
Yes.
When? Before you went to Chris Drive or after? When was the coke being done in the car?
Going to Chris Drive.
Going to Chris Drive. Who's doing it?
Keller, Quincy.
How are they doing it?
They like stop for a second. He stopped for a second, takes it out. And he puts on something. And then he rolls like, I don't know what the bill was, but he rolls it and it just like, snorted water.
Snorted off of something?
Yeah.
Were they handing it back and forth?
Yes.
And I ask you if you want some? They didn't ask you?
No.
Victoria?
They didn't ask me.
Did you ask for some?
No.
So, you're telling me that before you got to the house, you hadn't had any intoxicating substance that entire day? None. You're completely sober.
Yes.
And you were completely sober while you were standing there watching all this stuff. You're the only one that's completely sober, to your knowledge, while all this stuff's going on.
Yes.
Venetia hadn't had anything to your knowledge, has she?
No.
But you don't know.
And Venetia.
But you don't know what she. Did she appear to be intoxicated at all that night?
No.
All right, so after she was murdered, you all had this period of about an hour?
Yes.
And then Quincy said you all had to get her wrapped up, or I mean, how did that come about? Let's get that.
I was like, after like everybody had like done whatever, like their sex or whatever, mm-hmm. They happened after all that, and then we started have to wrap her up. But I didn't wrap her; I only wrapped the rope at the bottom.
You wrapped the rope at the bottom. All right. And you still don't remember how the car got to the back. I have no idea. You didn't drive it?
No.
You don't know who did?
No.
Okay, who carried her body out?
Cameron, Quincy. And Jeff.
Okay. Was the car backed up to the door?
I don't remember.
Okay. Who opened the trunk?
Jeff.
go up in the trunk.
I did.
All right. You opened the trunk. Did you have the keys?
Yes.
Who gave you the keys? But you didn't drive the car around.
No. I didn't know how to drive.
All right, so you opened the trunk up. And they put her in. Okay, then what?
Close the trunk. Then we don't trust the back door, we get into the car. Then we leave to go to the...
When you get in the car, was there a discussion about where you're going? Who's in where in the car?
Quincy's up front, Cameron's up front for Quincy. I'm still riding middle, and Jeff on one side, and you're still middle.
Okay. So what's the conversation? What's being talked about? If anything, what's being said? Come on.
They were just like,
what were they talking about?
There was nobody talking, because he was talking on his cell phone.
Who was he talking to? Who was he talking to?
Ronnie.
Who?
Ronnie.
Ronnie who?
Over
there. How do you know?
Because he always called me. He said, what's going on, Ronnie? But he said it's good.
A little earlier, I asked you if anybody had a cell phone. You said you weren't sure. So there was a cell phone.
Yes.
Okay. Is that the first time that his name came up?
Yes.
That's the first time? Name come up. See, I'm trying to figure out, you know what, I don't know the answer to it. And maybe you can help me, because I don't know. I want to know why Jessica Curran was murdered that night. Do you know? Okay, well, good. Why was she murdered?
She was going to tell Ronnie's wife that we're sleeping together.
Why was she going to do that?
From my understanding, she was pregnant or something like that.
Well, she wasn't pregnant. She wasn't pregnant.
We don't know. We don't know.
Who told you that?
Cameron.
When did she tell you that?
The very next day.
So you didn't know up to that point? You're saying that Quincy Croft got in a car and he called Ronnie Lear.
Yes.
On the cell phone.
Yes.
And told him
said what's going on, and he said it's done.
He said it's done. And did you know who he was talking to at the time?
Well, when I asked my cousin, and she like nudged him, and that's when he looked her and whispered something, and I asked my cousin who was talking. She said Ronnie.
You said Ronnie who?
Yes.
And she said what?
The cop.
Okay. So then what?
So then they carried on the conversation for a couple minutes, and then he held up the phone, and then we drove.
What were they saying? In the conversation.
She just kept saying it's taken care of. That's all I remember when she said it's taken care of.
Okay. What?
And then we drove to a gas station. And once he got gas in the cup, and then he got back in the car and he spit into a bottle and it spilled on his pants.
Okay. Do you know, where was it that he went to get the gas?
At the gas station right across the street from Majestics.
Okay. Did he pay for the gas?
I don't remember.
Just pull up and get gas and leave? Does that gas station stay open all night?
I don't know.
What time is it? You don't have any idea what time it is? But you went to that gas station?
Yes.
And they had gas?
Yes.
And it was open?
Yes.
And he got gas? And you don't remember if he paid for it or not?
No.
Then what'd you do?
Then we left the gas station, and then we got to like the corner of where the middle school is on the left hand side. And everybody basically said that we didn't get rid of the body. And so we just drove a little bit and we got to the next corner. And it was like, I got it. So we pulled over to the school, and we pulled over to the stairs. That's when Quincy and Cameron got out, and they went to the truck to go lift the body, but they couldn't lift it. It was too heavy. And then that's when Jeff got out, and he helped them carry the body. So we carried the body up there, and then that's when Vanisha went. She got out, and then she came after me, and I got out too. And then everything talks about, I just remember Quincy just pouring the gas and Vanisha just did a match. I just remember.
Where did he pour the gas? Did she have clothing? Did she have, was she still on the blanket or was she out on the ground?
I think she was on the ground.
What happened to the blanket?